testimony to her that so many people wanted to join us here tonight. So here's to that. And I want to get something straight. You know, we're not using this microphone for payback at all. No. You know, for example, what mom said about me in front of everyone I know at my birthday party, that's in the past.
Totally.
Yeah, your wedding. Yeah. Totally. That's old news.
It was not in our minds when we were writing this at all.
No, we're not going to get back at her for that. They were just words. I mean, they hurt for a long time. But we're good. And anyone who knows mom knows a few things about her. Right? Firstly, and most importantly, Mom has a really wonderful, phenomenal, tremendous sense of grammar. And she can correct your sentence like nobody's business. That's me, not I. Right? And sure, she's thoughtful and she remembers every detail about your life and she always tries to inspire confidence and bring out the best in you. And of course, she's always there for you when things are tough. But when it comes down to it, nobody fixes a dangling participle like my mother. Just watch out there. And one of my favorite stories about Mom is when she welcomed Jeff into the family with open arms. Actually, it was more like an outstretched hand in search of a glass. I don't know what that was about, but never figured that out exactly. But at dinner that night that they met, Mom and Jeff were having a really intimate conversation. They were sitting right across from one another. And it turns out, I found out later, that Mom was asking a lot of very intense questions about Jeff's growing up and what that was like. And he grew up in a town of 350 people. And what was that all about? And what was it like? And shocker, of course, she was asking very intimate questions. We know how she can be. But Jeff said he didn't feel like it was invasive. He felt like she cared. And he felt kind of honored that she took such a deep, penetrating interest in him. And that was really nice and moving. And he was moved by it. And I think it made a big impression on me. And when the questions stopped coming and the check came, he looked down to see that while he was bearing his soul, Mom had eaten his dessert. So another great quality of Mom, not to be forgotten, is her appetite. So if you haven't already made your way up there, you might just kind of go here quickly. So in honor of Mom, I did write a little bit of a song to celebrate her and wanted to share it with you. Let's see, haven't sung in a long time, so just bear with me here. Start this one, folks. We started at the end, I'm afraid.
We're not the Tarlins, for heaven's sake.
Yeah, no, really.
We're just doing the best we can.
We're working with what we've got here, people.
Jesus.
She is Lois, hear her roar. After that martini has been poured, tell the waiter not to throw the ice away. 'Cause she's eaten here before. This table's too close to the door. Dave, let's order so my steak is not delayed. Oh, yes, she is wise, but it's wisdom born of pain. She never pays full price, and she's certain to exchange. If she has to, she can do anything. She is strong. She is invincible. She is Lois. She built her business on the backs of mailmen carrying sacks who took her brochures out to the world. And weren't they all a bit surprised? The company wasn't run by guys, but by Lois and her fearless gang of gals. Yes, she is wise, but it's wisdom born of pain. She never pays full price, and she's certain to exchange. If she has to, she can do anything. She is strong.
Strong.
She is invincible.
Invincible.
She is flawless. She was raised on Richmond Road, and the legends still are told of perfection in school and home and life. She finally ditched her roommate Lou, and the entire committee too, and became such a good wife that she did it twice. Oh yes, she is wise, but it's wisdom born of pain. She never pays full price, and she's certain to exchange. If she has to, she can do anything. She is strong. She is invincible. She is loveless. So, happy birthday, Mom.